million years too early. This isn't music yet, because there's no change, but it will be. I'm 50% my mother, I'm also 50% my sister, but even though I have two woman halves, I am not a woman. I am half them the same way Enyola, 15, is half her mother Haleemat, and so is her little sister Faith, or Fethia, 13, whose second name either way is, or middle name either way is Patricia, because born on St. Patrick's Day. And so is her little sister, Amira, 10, who drew this map of their living room for me. You can pass it around, but I'm gonna need it back. So, they're all half their mother, and half each of their two sisters, which is three halves, which sounds like bad maths, but isn't. But just like I'm not a woman, there is no way to cut Enyola and Faith in half and stick any two of the four resulting halves back together to get their mother or their sister, or vice versa, as far as I know. And we're not going to try. This still isn't music, but we're getting there. This isn't bad maths, but it is bad genetics. It's truer to say that I have a 50% chance of sharing any given autosomal gene with my sister. So we're both 19,000 coin tosses. And some of those coins came up tails in me, and my sister, and our father, and his mother, and her father, and you get it. There's never been anybody who wasn't a collage of some other bodies else's. But wasn't also themselves. Because order matters. Because the same stuff, in a new order, is new stuff. But we are all still mosaics of mosaics. We are all still lots of people, if you round up. Including Haleemat and her three daughters. This is Amira, as seen by Amira.
I have brown eyes. I'm brown. And I have very small eyebrows. And I'm not tall.
Not that small. And this is Haleemat, as seen by Haleemat.
I'm light in complexion. I'm a beautiful woman.
She has an amazing laugh. And what are you like, Haleemat?
I'm a very humble person and hardworking.
She is very humble and very, very hardworking, a full-time student and mother of three, and officially part-time, but basically full-time hairstylist for all three daughters, because braids take ages. This is Faith, on what Faith sounds like.
So your special voice because there's a microphone on?
Yeah.
And what do you sound like when you don't sound posh?
More African.
More African?
Yeah. I use my Yoruba accent a lot.
Like.
Give me this. Put milk inside it, you know.
Put milk inside it?
Yeah.
Put milk inside it might be a Yoruba thing to say, but it's not any weirder than some of the things that Hiberno English does with prepositions. The head on you. I'm after saying it to him. We'll be dug out of that. So, Yoruba is a tonal language with three tones. Me, which means choice, which means change, which means music, finally, even with one voice, but more so when voices interlock. If everything is always the same, we're bored, and if everything is always changing, it's chaos. A pattern is when something changes while something stays the same. So the family are Yoruba, but the girls are Irish too. Sha Eniola e Kur Ifein in Ahma doing Askwaga.
Tome ka kuigwin de dish, tome mukone e hungar e bale boucher, e double 15.
They are both, both, and neither. We're all mosaics of mosaics, but I think the children of immigrants know it best and are extra mosaic-y. They are patterns. The saming and changing like melodies or tapestries, the familiar woven through and around itself until it suddenly isn't, because order matters. Before you even think about vowels and consonants, three tones means Yoruba has three possible words of one syllable, and three times three equals nine possible words of two syllables, which is what we're hearing now. Language, like food, like music, like DNA, like life, has relatively few ingredients. It's all about how you mix them up, because the same stuff in a new order is new stuff. This is a song Haleemat learned in school in Nigeria.
Education is good.
There's not a lot of subtext. Education is good. And this is a song in Yoruba that Amirat knows.
A now is a now. Chokoto pimpi is a chosa. Omi gari is a water. Eja dindi is a fish.
There's a lot of subtext there. And this is Haleemat being more patient with me than I deserve.
What is it?
Shobo Yoruba.
So, shobo?
Shobo.
Bo.
Yes.
Okay.
Shobo Yoruba.
And this is how the music of the language should sound.
Shobo Yoruba.
And 3 times 3 times 3 equals 27 possible words of 3 syllables. All before you think about vowels and consonants. With 12 vowels and 18 consonants, there are 272 million odd possible words. I hope you don't mind that I didn't have time to record all that. And one quartet of women equals 4 trios, equals 6 possible pairs, equals 4 solos, equals 4 people who are 15 different people, or who have 15 different facets at the very least. 15 different facets that can never all be catching the light at the same time. This is Amirat's impression of Faith.
It's so disgusting, leave me alone.
Yes.
And this is Haleemat's impression of Enyola.
When somebody enters our room, she just going away.
And this is Enyola on Faith.
Annoying in my space.
But just in case you think it's all annoying each other and being in each other's space and telling each other to go away and that you're disgusting, here are Faith and Amirat on their mother.
I look like her. Not really like her.
So you look like each other, but you're not like each other?
Yeah.
How are you different?
She likes working a lot. I'm lazy.
Why does she like to work a lot?
To show us how to like be a perfect mom when we grow up, no?
She's very pretty. And like that looks like her. She has long hair, and she has a beautiful smile, and a lovely nose.
Of course, there are 12 possible pairs, if order matters, and Enyola Faith is a different relationship to Faith Enyola, which of course it does, and of course it is, because no matter how close we are, or I suppose, the Faith that Enyola knows is not the Faith that Faith knows. And the Haleemat that Amirat knows is not the Haleemat that Haleemat knows. Because no matter how close we are to our loved ones, we're never inside their heads. So we're only ever pinging 1,000 sonar pings off them in the black of night on an ocean and stitching point to point to make an outline. Our best understanding of each other is a few seconds in the past and mostly empty space. And 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 equals 81 possible words of 4 syllables. With vowels and consonants, that's 176 billion possible words. You couldn't pay me enough. And this is what Haleemat thinks Enyola thinks about her.
She's not the type that loves to talk, so I don't know what she has in mind, but I know she will say something nice.
And this is what Amira thinks Faith thinks about her.
Very annoying.
Very annoying.
Yes.
It can feel a lot like being a ghost in a hall of mirrors, having a family. Like my reflection is realer and more solid than me. Like the only me's are me's on a beam. Or maybe you're not even a reflection, you're just the dark segment where all of their shadows vent, forced to change shape whenever they move, meaning it's hard to remember that they're just crossed shadows too. Einstein. He just put maths on what everyone with siblings knew already, that everything is not just relative, it's relatives. Lighter, darker, taller, shorter.
Taller than my sisters, and I'm lighter than Amira.
Just our skin complexion.
So they have the same understanding.
Nice eyebrows. A little bit of big nose. Light, light brown.
Huge.
We measure ourselves in terms of each other. There is no absolute scientific unit of self in a sealed room in France. We are never not ratio. So, four women, each half all of the others. But Haleemat's Nigerian and her daughters are Irish. She left 16 years ago, pregnant with Eniola, and Eniola sometimes doesn't understand her English, which Haleemat understandably doesn't love. When she was Faith's age, Haleemat remembers everyone in Nigeria being mad about Michael Jackson's We Are the World. But Faith prefers Alicia Keys. And at the risk of being that white guy from Americana, I mentioned Fela Kuti. And turns out Haleemat went to Calcutta Republic when she was 19, the same age I was when I first heard Zombie in my Leaving Cert music class. So I put it on. And we sang along.
Zombie, oh zombie. Zombie, oh zombie. Zombie, oh zombie. Zombie, oh zombie.
But Amira, obviously, prefers Billie Eilish.
Isn't it lovely? Hold on. Hard made of glass, my mind of stone.
And Eniola didn't want to pick a song. I didn't just leave her out because her taste in music makes ours look bad. Or anything. Haleemat and her siblings talk on the phone 3 or 4 times a week. She misses the weather. She doesn't miss the poverty or the corruption. But Ireland being Ireland, she doesn't have to. Her kids have been to Nigeria and come back, but they have never had to leave it like she did. Which is the thing, isn't it? I mean, it's the same for everyone, but the children of immigrants know it best. We want our children to want what we want for them, but never to want for what we want for them, if you follow. Only they can't. Because if you never want for something, then it's hard to want it much. The hollow has to lie empty long enough to echo, or you won't know it's there, much less care. A kid raised here, going to a school her peers in Nigeria would only get to go to if their parents were government or otherwise proper top-tier rich, doesn't think any more of that school than those kids in Nigeria do of the sunshine that we would kill for, even when we haven't just waited half an hour in drizzle like an endless, uncovered toddler sneeze in your face for a 39 bus full of coughing and links and racist side-eye for the plantain in your shopping bag to the city centre via the lost city of El Dorado. No wonder we sometimes get angry at them, kids, for having been given what we gave them because we wish somebody could have given it to us. No wonder we sometimes look at them and see cellos with bodies solid all the way through because of a fridge never empty whose door they leave open despite how many times have I told you. And because so solid, because of all we did and do for them, they don't need a special hard case with a velvet lining to keep someone from sitting on them and casually turning them to splinters. But, lacking lacks as they do, no matter how you saw their strings, they can never plaint, keen, pierce us. They can only whine, tinny and metallic, because all music worth the name is born in a hole.
Little girl blue.
be clear, I'm not talking about Inaoliji and Faith and Amira because they are good kids. I am under strict instructions to tell everybody that they are good, respectful kids who never enter a room without greeting their mother. If I were their brother, I would have to prostrate. Like this. Or like this. But because they're girls, they get away with one of these, right? Or if they're in Nigeria, one of these. Or so I'm informed. Unless they're just winding the white man up. But they definitely pray 5 times a day. Yeah. For the first time at 5 o'clock in the morning. Haleemat's phone goes off when it's time to pray because she has the app, Muslim Pro, which I find obscurely gas. And they definitely never ignore their mother like their white friends do theirs. And they definitely never interrupt her. But you know, they're not any less born in Ireland because they do those things. There is no way to cut them in half and stick them back together to get a little white Irish girl, or a little Nigerian girl, or their mother, or each other. It sounds like the maths shouldn't come out, but it does, because sometimes a half plus a half plus a half is one. And sometimes one immigrant parent plus one Irish upbringing equals one identity. They are collages, whole in pieces. There is nothing unique about them, except everything. And I am a little envious of how whole they are. Now, I struggle with faith. That's a lie. I've never had faith. What I struggle with is the Catholic Church, because it stole a quarter of my blood, which is roughly 3 pints, or exactly one grandparent I will never know. But Haleemat's faith is beautiful to me.
Yeah, I'm a friendly person and a religious woman.
Mm-hmm. There's an Arabic text on the wall. I ask her what it says.
There's only one God, and Muhammad is a messenger. There's only one God, and Muhammad is a messenger.
Prayer? Where's the groove in the world? But it's not unique in that, because that's what we do too. That's what everything does. It's all just grooves. Even if not all of them are danceable to or even legible by any stylist on any record player. Every object, just a habit, or a ritual if you prefer. It's only there as long as it's observed. The whole world a trill. A single note enduring by dying and dying and dying. Children, above all, are a prayer. Repeating us in a new order to become themselves. Repeating us until we are no longer us. Something dies, and something is born.